All right. Let's see. This is gonna be a this is gonna be a standard numpad build. My friend isn't gonna want the RGB, so I'll turn that off. Off. No. Wait. How do you turn it off? I don't know. Oh, there we go. All right, let's test this first. Make sure it's working. Yeah, this is plus sign, enter, 0, yep. They are not lining up. Why is that? That's weird. All right, let me reset this. Well, if it's making noise, that's probably a good thing. Is just being weird. Let me close that and start it up again. Okay. We'll just leave it here and see if these keys light up. Yep, 00, delete, enter, plus, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, numlock. Oh, I wonder if it's because I had numlock on, so this should be... Oh, wait a minute. These key mappings are different. Let me check something. Because I know this set has media keys and sort of a pattern to them. I don't know what's actually, like, standard or not standard. I think the darker ones were along the side. So I'll probably remap those keys. I took a picture because I played them out earlier. Play pause. Yeah, we'll do play pause. I did plus minus, but minus should be on the left. And then mute. I think that falls in line with the rest of the colors, yeah. Okay, yeah, let's go with that. So, play, pause, volume up, volume down. Volume down, volume up, and mute. Okay. So let's just test it one more time. Yep, that was definitely the mute button. Just to make sure these other switches work. Oh, I guess some of these won't light up unless I change the layout options, but all right, that's good. So in terms of switches, I'm gonna use Gateron KS3 switches. And this is to go in conjunction with the other TKL. It's not the same KBD fans TKL, the KBD Mark 8X. It's the Scarlet TKL that's a muted blue, which is darker than this kind of blue. So my friend also asked for a numpad to go with their TKL. So how many switches do I need? 1, 2, 3, 4. And then another 4 for the next row. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. So these are the numbers. Okay. And then 1, 2, 3, 4. Yep. So another 4 for the other buttons. Alright, so I have 2 switches left over. Alright, I don't need PCB right now. I probably won't finish this today. This is probably going to be a 2-part build. So I'll probably just be modding the... I'm just going to mod the switches and the stabilizers. So the stabilizers are included with this build, which I'm glad I didn't have to go hunt for stabilizers. And they are, I believe they're cherry clip-ins. Those are extra screws. So there's plate foam. I got a polycarbonate plate to kind of match up with the, I guess, palm plate. That I have for the TKL. And oh, here are the stabilizers. So I don't think I've ever used cherry clip-ins before. So when we have washers. Wait, are these clip-ins or screw-ins? These like look like screws to screw them in. Oh wait, no, they are screw-in. They're not clip-in. What was I saying? Yeah, these are cherry screw-in stabilizers, but they have like those weird feet that people say to clip off, which I don't know why cherry does that. I don't know why. I haven't found any explanation anywhere of like why that design is like that. Other than like modding videos where people say, take your trimmer things and snip those parts off. I guess they to like prevent the ticking. So looping this shouldn't go too badly. I think it's only like 17 switches I have to loop. Probably gonna just use this bag for bag lubing. So I should, yeah. I think today will just be switches and stabilizers. So I'm tempted to just use the stabilizers as is. I mean, like, not clip them, clip the legs. Because, like, presumably they're there for a reason. So I may try it out first. The only thing is that this PCB is a hot swap. Which isn't a big deal. I mean, I can still try using the, well, it's, the switch isn't gonna stay in. I'll figure it out as I go along. This one won't open. Okay, there we go. Actually, I'm gonna use this bag. Bag loot. Save these switches for another day. That's pretty lubed, so... Weezers. Alright, put these on. Loop stems, and then... play around some stabilizers. Oh great, I tangled them all. Fantastic. I'm gonna put on some gloves and do this with my fingers because it's faster that way. That's it for switches. I didn't notice a bent pin. Oh, this is one of the bent pins that I messed up. So the end is like really curled in on itself. Ooh. All right, there we go. Well, since I'm gonna have to solder this numpad, as long as I can get the switch seated properly, then a slightly bent pin shouldn't be an issue. Yeah, okay, the rest of these are fine. All right, stabilizers. All right, so I don't know how this is gonna go. I've never used these stabilizers before. So here are the stems. So there are exactly three sets of stabilizers. I'm gonna use this as my trash bag. Screws. Alright, I'll need the TPL 106. And here we have housings. Alright, and here we have wires. So let me see. Okay. That goes in there. Yep, so there's definitely some wiggle room around in the clip. I could probably get away with just Crytox XHT-BDZ. I don't think I want to holy mount these. Still curious why these stabilizers have little feet on the housing. Is it to cushion the impact? So they hit the bottom, but those little feet stick out. So, all right, maybe I will clip those little legs. Let's see what they're like. Oh, interesting. So, like, they aren't completely flush, but yeah, I wonder if that's gonna make a noise if I tap on it. So this is gonna be weird because the switch isn't like secured to the PCB. Definitely some wire rattle. Alright, you know what? I am going to I'm gonna clip the legs and then put some stabilizer pads on the board. The
also give me a chance to get rid of the stabilizer pads.
Oh, these are the KBD fans ones. Oh, I have two left. Even though I have three stabilizers. Oh, so I can only use it on like one set. I'm sure I have more.
So,
yeah, I'll just use these extra ones I have from what kit is that from? Owl Labs. For this, I could cut up the extra little pads on this sheet. Use them as holy mod on the stabilizers, but let's see what happens first with just the Krytox. samurai talks. Then I could always syringe loot them. Clip these little legs. Took a slightly more bigger, a slightly bigger chunk out of that one, but it should be fine. Slightly unbalanced. Yeah, this one's fine. Thing off. That's fine. That's fine. Yeah. Okay. So now we loop. That's better. Thank you. So, plumber's tape. Gotta be careful that you don't put more than you need. So you actually need very little. Just enough to go around like two or three times around the wires. What I found is the sweet spot. But I mean, this of course depends on the stabilizer that you use. So there are some stabilizers that have less space in between where the clip is and in between the clip and where the wire goes. And if you put it on too thick, it will actually make it harder for the wire to move around. So you don't want to do that. And if you're finding that, then it's just better to take that tape off and, you know, use a new one. The other option is to just use Krytox XHT BDZ instead and see if that gets you through the day. But using the plumber's tape does make it less messy. All right, now the other side. So, very non-scientific test, but I hope that the stab pads definitely help with leveling that out. Alright, let's see how this does with the switch. Oh, I should screw this in. Black washers. Oh, they're like adhesive. That's kind of interesting. Well, I guess it makes it a little easier to assemble together. Sort of. So they feel smooth, which is good. Stabilizers. Them stabilizers. All right, wires, tape. I actually might be able to solder this before I have to leave today. But if not, I'll solder it tomorrow, because I actually do want to solder a Hookah macro pad that I have sitting around. Have I never thought of this before? So these washers are on this plastic sheet. Oh, not all stabilizers come with this, but it's just a lot easier to insert the washers on the sheet and then pull it off onto the screw. Especially with these washers, since they do have a little adhesive on them to help stick to the PCB. But yeah, I know kids just have washers just standalone floating around in the bag. instrument things are these? It's just completely plastic? Interesting.
Well, I guess it cuts down on the material. You only need to mold one thing.
You know, I guess if it works, it works. Alright, let's try this one. Let's make sure the switch is flush. It's never so slight ticking, but it's a negligible amount. Not one I'm too invested to fix, but you know what? I'm just gonna
just put a very, very small amount of
dielectric grease in them. Just to help kind of mute out that tiny little sound. That's good enough. All right, and then the last one. Probably make a video about how I modify my stabilizers, because I know there are lots of other videos out there that say how to do, oh, that one's too small, Polymod, Epsimod, BokPop has one about using PTFE tape and plumber's tape, and there's Band-Aid Mod, different lubes you can use. My preferred choice, I know there's Cookie Curls has a mod that she likes to do. I kind of do this weird amalgamation of all of those different mods. This is too much, but it's okay. Plumber's tape, but kind of pushed a little bit off, but that should be fine. Sounds good. We'll put away my brushes, put away the tape. And I'm just going to put a drop of lube in there. So we have light foam. Yeah, it goes the way. Then a polycarbonate plate. Switches in. And I wonder if how this is mounted, because there aren't gaskets. Oh, it's probably top plate. So there are four screw holes here. So it's probably top mounted. Should I force break mod the case? Seems kind of unnecessary, but we'll see. I do have some extra foam like that I can put in the bottom to like also help mute it out if I need to. This one's a bent switch. Or a bent pin. Maybe I'll put the foam on this plate first, so I can line it up a little bit more easily. Oh, it goes around this part. That makes more sense. Yeah, good thing I did that. So switch pins, gotta make sure that they're seated properly. Some of them are not. Wait, yep, that row's good. Oh, this one has bent pin. This is my song. Lol, well, it's the instrumental, but I know the song. All right, that's good, that's good. There's no, yeah. All right, put this back in. Cool. All right, that one's good. That one's good. That is also good. Cool. All right. So all these switches are good. I'm gonna put in these other ones. Yeah. Yeah, that's right. All right, last switch. Cool. All right, so let's open this up and see what the deal is. Ooh, it came with an Allen wrench. Is this thing? It's just... Wait, what is this part? Oh, I guess it's a handle for the Allen wrench. So you can grip it. We'll put the feet on. Feet are very, like, round. Yeah. That sits nicely above the, desk mat. Alright. Who tightened this? Or like really, really tightened in there. There's very little space inside the case. Yeah, there's like no room for foam unless I really push it down. So it's, yeah, just 4 points to top mount it. Okay, that fits right in there. Oh, let me screw this down to see what it's like. Alright. So I'm gonna assume it's these little tiny screws. Thank you. They really added in a lot of extra screws for something that has like 8 screws total.
A smaller bag full of hardware.
I don't want to. Let me consolidate some of this stuff. I'll save this bag, I'll save this bag. So many bags in this kit. Let's make sure this cable works. Braid cable, cool. They included a little Velcro thingy, so convenient. Check you out real quick. You still work? Oh, this isn't gonna work because I didn't solder him in. But yeah, shows up. All right. So I'm gonna assume this cable works. And then that just fits right on. The whole thing screws together. Alright, so let me see if I do have some lying around. Oop. I really don't think this is gonna fit at all. But we can try. As doesn't really need it, and I'm probably gonna say no it doesn't. Let's see if this will even close. No, it does. All right. Ooh, and I cut it perfectly so it fits into the bottom case. I am so proud of myself for that. actually kind of like the shape of this numpad. It's not overly big. Just very... No frills to it. Just, it's a very practical kind of looking kind of numpad. I guess I can mount some keycaps on it. I don't remember what a numpad looks like. Let's see, 7 numlock, 4, 1, 0. There is some resonance though. Let's see, and I think I had this set as mute up there. Volume up, volume down. What is it? Division, multiplication, minus? Took a picture of this too. Division times and minus. Okay. There's definitely some case resonance, so can we try this phone that I have here as a case mod, and then if not, we can also force break mod it too. So, and then, what time is it? 4:15. I mean, I could solder it. I mean, it won't take long, but... it's a lot of, like, getting stuff out, putting stuff away. Yeah, I'll just save the soldering for tomorrow. I'll save it for tomorrow since I'm planning to solder anyway. Okay, so... wait, I also need to cut out a little space for the USB port. So, right up to here. Alright. See you. best roads. So, I can say that, you know, just a brief touching of the keys, it doesn't, not resonating. Yeah. Alright, cool. I guess we don't need four stuff now. Alright, so I'm going to. I actually will solder since I actually have time. It'll be quick. Alright, save this. Oh, Fang, you can't be here. Okay. Alright. Let me put some stuff away. My soldering equipment. And then I'll need to take this apart again. Oh, Android wants to update. Use this one. Oh, these are. This is... Yeah, I had some daughter left over from someone who was moving away, and they couldn't keep their. They're trying to sell a bunch of stuff. Sorry. Took this one. I actually don't know if it's leaded or not. But I don't think I'll be desoldering this Mac pad. This was... Is this opened? Oh, the plastic's still on. What was it? Let me see the other one. Oh, maybe neither of these things were used. Alright. I don't want to test that, so I'll just use what? It's audio. No, that's the smaller. Switch pins, where are you? There you are. Oh, hey, Mad Asian. It's going good. I just doing a quick build for MacFab. I need to basically head out soon. But yeah, it's going good. Rebuilt my frog this morning, actually. Used different switches. And put a Ruby on it, which I like a lot better. Better than Saku's and GMK Dracula that I did last night. That should be it. We get all the pins. So top row should have 4 switches. Next row 4. Yep. That's fine. Same with like boards that support multiple types of switches, not just the MX cherry style. It's that sometimes those holes overlap, and then I end up getting solder in like the whole thing instead of just like around the pin, but it's find it hard to like cool. What was I saying? I find it hard to just keep the solder localized around the switch pin without having it like flow into the rest of the stuff. Alright, cool, this works. 4:30. Yeah, that didn't take long at all. I don't know why I thought this was gonna take forever. I just need to let everything cool down, especially the iron. Alright, let me clean some of the stuff up and get this out of the way. Thank you. I'll bring it out with the I'll show the macro pad with the other TKL that it's going with. It's again a map in color, but my friend originally agreed to a TKL, and they didn't realize the keycap set was included. So they assumed, like, the keycap set, which supports a full size, was the keyboard they were getting. Even though I explained to them, like, the different components, or at least the tangible components that someone would see on a daily basis, which is basically the case on the keycaps. I didn't even go over switches. So, even though I explained to this person, you know, what I was going to build, and, you know, deciding on color and whatever, they apparently thought that, or whatever they thought in their head was not what I was basically telling them. So either I've known this person for a while, so it could just be a matter of them not understanding technically what it is. Could be me not explaining it very well. I mean, it's probably both. Anyway. And just very unclear expectations, possibly. I mean, it's not a big deal. Even if this person, I mean, there aren't that many full sizes anyway, so it's hard to. It was gonna be a long shot to find that. I mean, the one exception being the KBD 8X Mark II 8X. But they're all out of stock of their TKLs. And they wanted to have had the thing that, or the particular color that my friend was looking for anyway. Alright, this can be trash, my friend won't need this. I'll give him the cable and the Allen wrench. I'm like, yeah, everything else is trash. I'm not gonna bother giving them the extra hardware because. So. How long will this take down to cool? No, it's still warm. Okay. Extra hardware might get confusing. I mean, it's already confusing, like, building with extra hardware. It's like, there were so many extra screws that came with this kit, and there are only 8 screws total, so 4 to top mount, 4 to put it together. And I'm just throwing in some extra phones so it doesn't, like, you don't get as much resonance from the case, which I managed to cut very nicely, just blind. I cut it based on this. And it just fits perfectly. So, put this on, screw it all together. Oh, right, I need that Allen wrench. And there it is. The KBD pad Mark II. All right, so let me plug this in. Actually, I'll save that for the TKL. Let me bring out the tickle. I was looking at a numpad recently, and I really need one. I mean, numpads are cool. MacroPads are cool. They're nice to have. Whoops. Let me move this hardware back. You up here. Yeet. So yeah, it almost kind of blends in together. Whoa. Let me move my Olivia keyboard. Get rid of this trash. So yeah, that's basically it. Yeah, it almost looks like it blends in with each other. So, I mean, under a bright light, it's going to look different, but you know what? Now you have modularity. Let's give this a spin. Oh, what is my cat doing? Trying to do a typing test. Is that what you guys want to hear? I'll do a typing test. Although, I don't think there's any numpad typing tests. Numbers? Oh, sure, why not? You can do numbers in monkey type. Let's see how this goes. All right, let me adjust the microphone. And then remove the suppression filter. Okay.
mods over here. Like, I don't know if that's just because there's more space, but it sounds like a PBT keyboard. Alright, numpad. This has, yeah, this has silicone feet. Then this has. Make yourself comfy. I'm glad these typing angles matched up because I was afraid that was going to be a huge concern. I like the sound. It's not. Yeah, there's some case resonance, but yeah, it's pretty good in my opinion. Okay. Let's see, 446. I'm gonna put the TKL away. And you know what? I'm gonna force pick mod the numpad. And then I think that'll be it. Oh, I should leave this out because I need to take pictures of it to send to my friend anyway. Too big. Just right. Oh wait, no, both of them were too big. Noise suppression filter, reactivate. So force break mod, I want to put little pieces of tape around these top screw holes. So these are going to be like really tiny, tiny pieces of tape. What does she want? I don't know. Probably food. Like always. Thank you.
What else is there in life? Food is so good. That is, that's true. Where's my other piece of tape though? It's on the scissor. Past tense of force break bond, force break modded. I work to eat, or I work because I want to eat lots. Both are pretty spot on. Yeah, keyboards too, because I can't eat keyboards. Food's more important than keyboards though. I just need a tiny bit more, and then we shall be done. Oh, it's not even 5 yet. It's almost 5. Tough to eat keyboards, even if the switches sound tasty. Yeah, like marshmallow switches. Halu switches. KTT strawberry switches, got sea salt lemon switches, rose switches. Hippo switches. Kiwi switches, tangerine switches. Oh, this piece sucks. Dragon fruit switches, which I've heard are not very good. There were blackberry switches, which isn't a thing anymore. Banana split switches. What is BCPS? I might have put a little extra tape there, but that's okay. All right. So here is a numpad with just a bunch of little mods. Tape mod. Plumber's tape on the wires, XHT BDZ on the wires, 205 grade zero on the stabilizer stem and housing. Also clip the little legs off the stems, stabilizer stems, because they're cherry stabilizers. No holy mod, no Ipsy mod. Also put a little dielectric grease and just plug up the butt. Not sure, but I've never tried to eat a hippo, but I'm pretty sure I just might be an appetizer to them. Alright, well, there's still some resonance, but only towards the bottom, so... I don't think there's anything I can do about that. But I will call this done. Is this hot? No. Okay, good. Put it away. don't do what I did and touch soldering iron tips. Because you don't want to burn yourselves. Okay. Let's see. Oh, is that it for cleanup? Yeah, I'm just gonna toss some trash away. Put this away. Oh, I can take pictures and send them to my friend right now. So, yep. Whoa. Here we have Maker keyboards. Scarlet TKL in muted blue. With Gateron KS3 switches. I think I put house tabs in them. And then added some case foam into the bottom. It's a gasket O-ring mount. And with a PVT keycap set that I got from AliExpress. And then KBD pad mark too. So dark blue, muted blue. This has foam in it. This has force brake mod, and then cherry screw and stabilizers. So yeah, that's it. Then I will be giving this keyboard to my friend. Cool. All right. Well, I wasn't anticipating building a macro pad, but it arrived today, and I was like, well, I might as well get started on this. And it went by very quickly, because I don't think I've built a macro pad before. Keyboard's not plugged in. Let's find someone to raid. Alright, let's go see who's online. Oh, so many people are online. Oh, let's go raid. Hold on. I'm waiting for some pre-roll ads to finish first, and then we'll see what we're gonna do. See, Courtney's doing GMK Noir unboxing. Oh, she's looking at stuff. Jack Piketty. Okay, you know what? Let's go raid Jack Piketty because he's been raided by like 5 different people. So let's do that. Let's keep it going. Oh wait. Let's do a raid message. 1, 2. Do the kung fu. There. Okay. Cool. Here's a raid message. All right, everyone, stay safe, have fun. Get some sun, but wear sunscreen. And we'll go raid Jack Piketty. All right. Thanks everyone for hanging out. See you later.
Later or earlier today, but I gotta do this.